It is about the how do you allocate resources, and that is done on a refreshing way. It is a way of sharing any resource. That's part of the culture to do so. And again, we have here written that, it's published last year, about economics, how the economics work in the rural areas. I won't go into it. It is not what people think it is, but it's an African economic experience. Still a lot of study to be done, but a unique landmark paper has come out of it. Then there is another thing. How is information and knowledge being transferred? Well, that's done the oral way, not by writing, certainly not in rural Africa. The writing is mainly for Western consumption, the way to show and to talk about it. That's the way it's being transferred. And for Western people, that's quite puzzling. Again, this is being published, how to do that. Because if you want more to know about this kind of stuff, there is a lot of references here. Up, click and go. And recently, in September 2011, I published a book about it, which you can freely download on this site. It's called Placemark, talks about observation in rural Africa, and it goes from philosophical observation to technical observation to just daily life. But all these references are here. Thus, what is needed now? Why am I standing in front of you here in Tilburg? In my view, I'm calling for research that is sensitive to culture and context. Crucial stuff, and very often overlooked. In my view, everybody needs to do that everywhere. Of course, we want to do what the customer wants everywhere, but there is a uniform context and culture here from the academic world, the technical world, and the customers. And that those three is not necessarily there in rural Africa or anywhere else in the world. All these dynamics of how you deal with knowledge and how you deal with people and how that all interacts, the perspectives, the role models, preconceptions, it is all we need to study. And this isn't generic that we need to study these kind of things. It's valuable all over the world. But when we do it in a situation like we have done in rural Zambia, we find unique input that is really helping forward. We need to validate, mobilize and broker to innovate, educate and enterprise. But very importantly, such should be done on balanced partnerships. Here Desmond Tutu is talking about that. I won't play the video right now, but it talks about what leadership is. And one of it is suffering, the other one is serving. Very important stuff. And we must not misunderstand that many of the resources are in the West and they come with Western rules to the South. And if you don't do it like that, then you don't get the resources. But that's not how it should be. It needs to be balanced in all partnerships. And then we can truly learn from each other. So thinking of inclusiveness, structuring in hybrids, outcome in cooperation, and valuing of engendering in humans. This is valid everywhere. But in our environment, it becomes really important, and otherwise we have no output. We have transdisciplinary challenges here, and that's where we can study together. You know, how do we sustain a togetherness? How do we share common values over the world? How do we support social cohesion? And how do we network these social units? And so on and so on. All kinds of very important questions which we are dealing with. And they come up so much when you work in the internet environment, because it's, again, the internet is an undercurrent that is supporting all our interactions nowadays. The borders have gone. Internet is now our highway of information. But these are things that we do need to look into so we have balanced partnerships over the world. And that's what we have learned in rural Africa. And we are dealing with these. We go forward. I think we have made a lot of discoveries in the Maché environment in Zambia, published about it, and we challenge you to cooperate with us, and we cooperate with you and build these relationships to study these kind of things.